about it, but a good segue. Like Sarah said, waitlists are tricky. We don't really recommend you rely on a waitlist, especially during your first quarter. Get, like they said, get what you can take for your first quarter, and then the subsequent quarters will be a lot easier for you. However, if you do choose to waitlist, one important thing is the way they add you from a waitlist is it's next in line, but it's also next in line based on who's eligible. So say you sign up for a class, but you don't technically need that prereq, and you haven't contacted the major department to have a pre-authorization done for that class. If you're next in line but you don't have a prereq, they're going to skip over you and take the next person. If you do meet the prereq and they do add you on, like I said, you're going to get an email saying you've been added into such and such a class. However, let's say you decide you don't want to take that class anymore. You're going to be staying in that class until you physically go on and you drop it from your schedule, and that's a big thing you want to be aware of. So if you wait list a couple class and you get added to them and decide you don't want to take them, it's your responsibility to go and make sure you drop that class. You can only wait list one section of a course. So say you want to wait list, I don't know, Math 20F, okay? You're waitlisting Math 20F. But there's another section, time, of Math 20F that you want to try waitlisting. You can't do that. You can only waitlist one of the Math 20Fs or whatever it is you're trying to waitlist. And again, a waitlist, just because you waitlist does not mean that you're going to get a spot in there. And then also the waitlisting, like Sarah said, to touch upon again, if you waitlist in a class, that takes up some of those 19 minutes that you can register in or get a spot in. So if you're waitlisted for some, but you find like a COM 120 is available, and it fits in your schedule, take the COM 120. Don't rely on whatever it is